Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Understanding CTCSS and DCS. In this short presentation, we'll explain the basic technical principles behind CTCSS and DCS, and how they're used in two-way radio systems. Let's start by discussing Squelch. We can define Squelch as a technique that's used to suppress the audio output of a radio receiver. In other words, a radio with Squelch enabled produces no audio output until it receives a signal that breaks Squelch. There are two types or kinds of Squelch. The first of these is noise Squelch, which suppresses background noise or static. The user configures a level, and audio output remains off or squelched until the received signal level exceeds this squelch level. The main purpose of noise squelch is to prevent listener fatigue. With squelch enabled, there's no static or hissing sound coming from the radio between received transmissions. The other type of squelch is user squelch, which either allows or suppresses transmissions from certain users. Unlike noise squelch, user squelch is not based on the received level, but rather on some type of code or tone embedded in the transmitted audio. Regardless of the received RF level, there's no audio output unless the correct code or tone is received. There are two main applications of user squelch. One is the creation of talk groups, where transmissions from users outside of that group are suppressed. The other main application is access to repeaters, where the repeater will not retransmit a signal unless it contains the proper tone or code. This prevents the repeater from being inadvertently activated by noise, spurious emissions, etc. Let's look at a couple of examples. Here, some of our radios are configured to use the blue squelch tone, or code, and other radios are configured to use the red squelch tone, or code. When a blue radio transmits, the other blue radios will open squelch and hear the transmission, whereas the red radios will remain squelched. Similarly, when a red radio transmits, this would only open squelch on the other red radios. Repeaters are often configured to only retransmit signals that are received with a given squelch tone or code. For example, if this repeater is configured with the blue tone or code, then transmissions received from radios using that same tone or code will be repeated, whereas noise or transmissions from radios using other tones or codes would not be repeated. Repeaters don't normally pass tones, but a repeater may insert the same tone, a different tone, or no tone at all into the repeated signal. The user squelch tone or code is typically either manually configured by selecting from a list of values, or is programmed into the radio. In cases where the tone or code is not known, a radio may have a tone scan function that tries each possible tone or code until it determines which one, if any, is in use. It's important to remember that user squelch does not provide any kind of privacy or encryption. It's simply a way to avoid hearing radios that you don't want to hear. For example, a radio without any user squelch configured will hear transmissions from both the red as well as from the blue radios. User squelch also doesn't prevent users of different groups from talking over each other, and may actually make the problem of talkover even worse, since users in one group may not hear when users in a different group are using the same channel. The first type of user squelch we'll discuss is called CTCSS, or Continuous Tone Coded Squelch System. This is the most common implementation of user squelch in analog radio systems. CTCSS works by inserting a continuous analog tone into the transmitted audio, and the receiver will only open squelch if the configured tone is detected in the received signal. CTCSS is standardized and supported by many manufacturers, and is primarily used in FM at VHF or UHF frequencies, although it could be used for other bands or modulation types. You may also hear CTCSS referred to as tone squelch, or PL tone, PL standing for private line, a term trademarked by Motorola. There are 50 standard CTCSS tones in the range of 67 to 254.1 Hz. Note, however, that some radios don't implement all of these tones, and some radios even use non-standard tones. Recall that these tones are transmitted continuously while the useful voice or other audio is being sent. Although these frequencies are low enough that they're called subaudible, it is possible for some humans to hear them. Therefore, receivers usually remove these tones using a low-pass filter before the speaker or audio output. The other common form of user Squelch is called DCS. DCS stands for Digitally Coded Squelch, and, as the name implies, is a digital form of user Squelch. Similar to CTCSS, DCS inserts a code into the transmitted voice, with the code being in the form of a three-digit number. This three-digit code is encoded into a 23-bit word that is sent as continuous FSK, or frequency shift keying, data at approximately 134 bits per second. And like CTCSS, filtering is required to prevent harmonics of this FSK signal from creating audible noise. DCS has the advantage that it provides many more codes than CTCSS, but is less commonly used. Let's look at the DCS code word for the code 023. Each digit is encoded in 3 bits, and a special bit sequence, called the signature, is required in bits 10, 11, and 12. 11 check bits are used to detect any errors, and the word is transmitted in the order of least to most significant bit. Since each digit of the DCS code is 3 bits long, there are potentially 8 to the third, or 512 possible DCS codes. This is, of course, significantly more than the standard 50 tones used in CTCSS. However, in practice, only a subset of these codes are used, usually about 100. The main reason for this is that different DCS codes can result in the same 23-bit pattern, only shifted in time, so a careful selection of DCS codes can help to avoid the potential of duplications. ETCS 103.236 specifies a subset of DCS codes to use, but in practice, many manufacturers make their own decisions about which subset of DCS codes they support. In standard DCS frequency shift keying, a negative frequency shift indicates a logical zero, and a positive frequency shift indicates a logical one. In some cases, however, DCS systems will employ inverted polarity, usually to avoid interference or other issues. There's no way to detect if a system is using normal or inverted polarity, so this must be configured on the radios. In some cases, DCS codes are preceded by a plus sign or a minus sign to indicate which polarity is in use. One additional feature of DCS is the turn-off code. This optional code is used to avoid hearing a squelch tail or a crash at the end of a transmission. When the user is finished speaking, the turn-off code is enabled, and this instructs the receiver to close squelch, that is, mute the audio output, before the received RF drops. The duration of this turn-off code is configurable, normally in the range of 100 to 300 milliseconds. Note that a similar function can be performed in some CTCSS systems by reversing the phase of the analog tone at the end of the transmission. This is, however, not a standard feature in CTCSS, and is usually referred to by vendor-specific names, such as reverse burst, or STE for squelch tail elimination. Let's summarize what we've learned. Generally speaking, there are two kinds of squelch. Noise squelch, which suppresses audio output when the received RF level falls below a configured threshold, and user squelch, which suppresses audio output unless a defined tone or a code is received, allowing receivers to only hear transmissions from certain users. The two most common forms of user squelch in analog radio systems are CTCSS and DCS. CTCSS sends a subaudible analog tone at a certain frequency, whereas DCS sends an FSK-modulated digital code. Both CTCSS and DCS provide similar functionality, including the creation of user groups, as well as repeater access. This concludes our presentation, Understanding CTCSS and DCS. Thanks for watching.